humanity has gone to the peaks of perversion. Now you don't even enjoy directly. See, even if you are with your senses down to earth, physical, transforming you is always possible. The possibility is always available. Because our masters have created powerful methods, techniques, kriyas to transform you. If you are addicted to something directly of five senses, eating, touch pleasure, seeing, listening, smelling, if you are directly addicted, at least you have a solution, possibility of transformation. I tell you, when you are directly using your senses to enjoy, when the senses retire, it gives you the maturity and you become ripe. You are now ready to relax into the restful awareness. But when the perversion happens, human beings get into the space where curing, transformation, healing becomes almost impossible. Cinema visually presenting some concepts to you, cinema brought one of the major problem to humanity: old age sexual perversion. Please understand, even when your senses are tired and retired, mind is not tired or retired. Mind is too active, but body has lost the capacity. This is the main reason for old age perversions. All the old age perversions happens just because of cinema. And of course, cinema is soft pornography. From there, naturally, hard pornography. Understand? If you stop with the natural growth, you take birth, you assume a human body, you get physically matured, and you enjoy all the senses and pleasures, and you grow, your body is tired, and you retire, you will be out of the need for pleasure. But humanity does not even know the meaning of the word natural growth anymore. It's almost like a Matrix movie. The artificial intelligence which you created has taken over the humanity. The moment cinemas entered human life, visual presentation, the possibility of visual presentation has entered human life, the old age perversion became part of lifestyle. I can tell you, now with the internet entering into human life, becoming part of the humanity, one of the worst perversion is happening. Not just old age perversion, youth perversion. I tell you, billions, please understand, I am not using the word millions, I am saying billions have become psychologically impotent. they are no more qualified, capable of living their life. They are no more capable of living their reality. They lost connection with the reality. Reality is no more part of their life. Just today, I was reading a joke. One guy is sitting under a tree reading a book on how to play computer game about golf. See, playing golf, there's a computer game. I'll show you the scene. Two guys are sitting under the tree. And why don't you project that one? One guy is asking, what did you bring to read? The other guy is answering, it is a book of tips for my new computer golf game. So you are reading a book about computer stimulation of an activity that is almost a sport. That is about as close as you can get to being a non-organic life form. And this chap, the guy is saying, this chapter is about driving the little cart. First thing, golf itself is a game for the old people, where you don't move anything. And that golf is coming in computer. Inside your screen, you are going to play the whole golf. That's the second funniest thing. Third, you are not even playing, you are reading a book about playing. Human beings have almost become vegetables. Please understand, this is one of the biggest danger happening to humanity, especially to youth. You are moving away from reality. You may think, online addiction is such a simple problem. Why is Swamiji talking about this online addiction so much? Please understand, it is not such a simple problem. It is a pattern deeply rooted in a big disorder. Very big disorder. Online addiction is an engram rooted in the deep disorder. Disorder of not able to be alone. Please understand. A recent study in Stanford University of School of Medicine says one out of every 8 persons, means 12.5% is suffering from some form of internet addiction. 12.5% of the human population. I think even alcohol, people are not addicted this many percentage. I don't think 12.5% of humanity is addicted to alcohol. But 12.5% of humanity is addicted to internet. Degeneration of youth primarily is happening with various online addictions. Online addictions include obsession to watch pornography, obsession to spend several hours on the internet, either playing games, socializing on the internet, includes indulging in sexual acts on the internet like chat sex. Psychologists are now claiming that online addictions have similar adverse effects as other more publicized addictions like drugs and alcohol. Please understand, if you are addicted to alcohol or drugs, what all dangers you face in life, disturbances you face in life, you go through the same sufferings with online addiction also. The after effect of the online addictions is disastrous. Online addicts are left with no social life, no self-confidence, lonely, shy, anxious, depressed. Their life is taken over by this addiction, causing them to forego basic responsibilities. See, when somebody is addicted to online, even the basic responsibility, like taking bath, eating, studying, playing, even these things disappear. One of the worst thing is that they get completely disconnected with other human beings, completely getting into a shell of their own, leading to a disastrous social, academic and behavioral problems. Unfortunately, internet becomes their one and only medium of socializing. I can see how people, even if both of them are sitting in the same room, they only send a message through chat or Twitter. I love you. I miss you. Human beings forgot how to relate looking into the eyes. See, when you look into the eyes of somebody and say, I love you, you open up. You are inviting the person to enter you. But with the internet, it is a lot more easy. I tell you, every time when you look at somebody's eyes and say, I love you, it's a spiritual practice. For those few moments, whoever it may be your child, it may be your father, it may be your beloved, it may be your boyfriend, it may be your girlfriend. If you are looking into the eyes and saying, there is a conscious transaction. Every conscious transaction, either by bringing joy or suffering, transforms you. Please understand. Every conscious transaction, either by bringing joy or suffering, transforms you. But understand, when you are on the Twitter, I love you, I miss you, you are the most handsome man in the planet Earth. You are the beauty queen of the planet Earth. You can go on lying because you know for sure the other person cannot find out you are lying. I receive like this hundreds of tweets. But I always ask them, thank you for the compliment, but do you really mean what you say? See, when you look into the other's eyes and say, the other person will find out whether you are telling the truth or not. But with internet, you don't need to. Nobody will find. Please understand. You completely get disconnected from the reality. That is the one of the biggest problem. You don't know real love. You don't know real fear. You don't know real greed. You don't know real jealousy. I tell you, only the real fear can be transformed. Real lust can be transformed. Real jealousy can be transformed. Real love can be transformed. There's a beautiful incident from Ramana Maharshi's life. Ramana Maharshi was lying down on the couch. Somebody goes to Bhagavan and says, Bhagavan, please give me a little sacred ash. Bhagavan says, it is there in the cup, please take it. It is there in a small coconut shell. He says, please take it. The devotee says, no, 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 no. Bhagavan has to give from his hand. Ramana Maharshi says, eh, that hand and this hand both are Bhagavan's only, please take it. Then the devotee is not ready to listen, he just gets that vibhuti, puts it at the feet of Bhagavan and takes it. Bhagavan laughs and says, you are not touching the real Bhagavan by touching that feet. You are only touching the house of the Bhagavan. Understand, he says, even while Bhagavan's feet was touched, he says, eh, you are not touching Bhagavan by this. You are only touching the house of the Bhagavan. Even touching the body, he says, is only a perverted understanding of touching you. If somebody touches your body and says they touched you, please understand, it is only perverted understanding. It is not straight touching. Now, one of the biggest addiction for the modern youth is kissing the home page of your boyfriend or girlfriend. See the perversion from which limit going to which limit. Here is Bhagavan, even if you touch his feet, he says, you are touching only the house where I am living, not me. But it is so unfortunate. Even our love has become so perverted. You lost the capacity of real love. Internet became a place practically where you live, and not only that, please understand, you build pseudo identities. That Facebook internet farming, online farming, you buy eggs and that eggs hatch, and that hens again lay eggs and that eggs hatch again, you go and feed them online, you practically live. I tell you, unless I go through this, I cannot find a solution for this. So I went through this whole thing. For last few days I was meditating on this. And I downloaded many of the information. People who have online farming, within 20 days see their online farm in their dream. Please understand, I am giving you some of the important sacred secrets of online addiction. If you are having your own online farm or fishes, within 20 days you see the effect of that in your dream. In your dream you will wake up, oh, I have not fed my fishes online, I have not taken care of my hen in online, I have not taken care of my online farm. Within 20 days, you experience this.